Welcome to a new daily top Askreddit video. Today's topic: if real life was a video game, what would be some loading screen tips? There are no checkpoints, so be careful. When you are killed, you die. If you die in Russia, you also die in real life. People respond differently to you if you are naked and forward slash or have a weapon drawn. Bear in mind when developing relationships. So real life is just modern Skyrim. Hey you, you're finally awake. Money can be exchanged for goods and services. $20. I wanted a peanut. $20 can buy many peanuts. D. If your character is not physically appealing to NPCs, try investing points in the humor skill tree. Or grind the economics skill. Or level up your physical strength. While your face can't naturally change, your body can, to an extent. Think carefully before interacting with NPCs. They may remember how you treat them and what you say. Past interactions will color future interactions. Life is just a long telltale game, isn't it? The difference with life and a telltale game is that life has choices that make a difference. Risking farts helps increase player comfort, but it can damage your social standing sometimes dramatically. A girl I liked invited me over when her parents were away. I farted while we were sharing a small couch and she kicked me out of her house. If I hadn't have farted, my children would have had different faces. Yo, this ain't it the person you wanna be with. But don't fart on people that uncomfortable with it, you need to build to farting rights. Just because all the other players have completed a mission, doesn't mean you have to focus on the same one. Thank you. The more you move your body, the easier it will be to move your body for the duration of your character's journey. But watch out for injuries that can give you permanent debuffs. And if you play on hard mode, these debuffs start from the very first level. The charisma statistic may not seem to affect gameplay mechanics outside of dialogue, but in fact informs overall difficulty settings. Yuri, so my 1/10 attractiveness rating is okay, cause I got a solid 10/10 charisma. Edit. By attractiveness I meant my physical looks. I am a self-admittedly ugly person. However, I would like to think I have a nice personality, and I am generally well-dressed and spoken. That's how I defined attractiveness and charisma in my comment. A tale as old as time. Warning, permadeath enabled. Not if you max out Buddhist skill tree. r/thefrigelite would like to disagree. Beware of side quest Reddit, it will slow your progress on the main game. But the side quests are what level you up to be prepared for the main quest. Not with this quest. The XP gains are so low that it has basically no practical effect. It's essentially a minigame that provides no loot or any other tangible benefits. Side quest school is a much more efficient way of leveling. Be careful about choosing your sexual encounters, you can never unfuck somebody. Oh boy, I wish I had learned that sooner. Same, never going back to jail. Don't stick your dick in crazy and forward slash or don't let crazy stick their dick in you. Will result in heartbreak, mental anguish, loss of funds, potential physical damage and definite emotional damage, and high probability of loss of possessions. Possibly by fire. Check. 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 Add check. That sure was a tumultuous time in my life. Little Toe's hitbox is bigger than the model, beware. Life tip, regularly drinking water replenishes most stats over time. Edit, removed explanation of my original edit. Regularly drinking alcohol reduces resistance over time. Regularly drinking alcohol reduces all stats over time, especially responsibility and intelligence. Fire hurts and you take fall damage. Oh, this game does have fall damage. I thought about jumping off my roof, but this ruined my plans. Objects in mirror are closer than they appear. Frozen waffles can be purchased at most food markets. Look both ways before crossing a street to avoid being hit by a car. She'll never be your girlfriend if you never talk to her. Oh boy, that last one really hit me hard, man. Remember to always sleep early for extra energy points. Okay, Morga, I'll go to sleep. Remember to pay off your debt. Or train yourself to run faster. Taxman has speed cheats on. You can't escape him. Licking doorknobs is illegal on other planets. Well, that's my life plan ruined. Toasters are not a good substitute for bath bombs. Oh, that's why my kids keep dying. What kind of fucked up sim scenario are you running? Choose your starting class carefully because each gets vastly different gear at the end of the tutorial. And reclassing is expensive and time-consuming. Like how if you want to become an art student but instead find being a dictator is a better option. I wanted to choose scientist, but my intelligence stat is 4. I've somehow multiclassed into both scientist and artist. The Mimaxic sounded good at the time, but now I'm a glass cannon and stuck with an inferior build for both questlies. Ensure finding a companion while still low level, as it gets harder as you level up. Instructions unclear. Now in prison. That's okay, you should have one lockpick to get to freedom. Avoid the extra chromosome perk during the character build. It sounds helpful, but will likely be more of a hindrance. The wiki, this is a hidden hard mode. It is not recommended to activate this the first time you play through. Hard to avoid RNG. I hear some high-level players are working on a stem cell and gene therapy hacks to change a character's RNG seed though. Respawns are disabled in this mode. Hardcore mode. You can use alcohol to temporarily boost your charisma and reduce your stress meter, but remember that this will also temporarily lower your dexterity and intelligence stats. Also, be aware that the buffs don't simply stack, they have diminishing returns then become debuffs. Why are you playing such a fucking awful game? The intro sucked. Admit it, you've forgotten it. The tutorial was 18 years long. Your best skill tree is laundry, exams or safe driving. You get one life. You can't respawn. You constantly have to eat and drink. Your companions are dicks. To unlock the helicopter takes a shit ton of grinding. This is a shitty game. And the story fucking sucks. Wait, there's a story. I've been going about it all wrong, I thought it was open world. If you have plans after date, do not eat garlic bread. If you did eat garlic bread before plans, make sure to share. Also, if you may have plans after date, find a way to low-key relieve your bowels. You don't want a tummy ache to get in the way. Improve your intelligence stat by using your phone less during class. The social stat is always in the negatives, so be careful when leaving the house. Look out for objects on the ground. You, the player, lack depth perception. Answer carefully when talking to NPCs or other players. They could be on 1 HP and really need support. Be sure to drink plenty of water and eat enough food to reduce the chances of status effects such as fatigue, dizziness, fainting, weakness and in extreme cases, getting a game over. To remove some status effects and raise your energy gauge, get some sleep in a bed. I got bored lol. That fourth one really makes you think. You really never know who's on their last HP. Sometimes the last HP is worth the same as the rest of the health bar. Use birth control. Character creation is a lot more fun when you don't actually make a new character. And replaying character creation mission over and over again. Don't eat yellow snow. Also don't get your dick caught in a sliding glass door. Instructions unclear, got dick stuck in toaster. Stay hydrated. Check your posture. This actually helped lol, I realized I was hunched over like a lot and sat up straighter. Not all nice people want to have sex with you. Not all people who want to have sex with you are nice. Start saving for retirement early. That shit compounds. If it's late night, and you see two guys approaching, you better have your running skills high. Condoms cost a couple bucks, raising a child to age 18 can cost well over $200,000. Not bathing or washing your clothes will affect interaction options and outcomes. The more attractive you are, the more easier life will be for you. Attractive people are just pussies playing on easy. Then I'm on ultra hardcore mode. Can't help it if I got good roles during character creation. Produced by a relative of Tyrannosaurus, eggs go great in ramen. Don't stress yourself, it's just a game. Crippling depression is a permanent debuff with no known cure, only some treatments that widely vary in their effectiveness. Crippling depression is a permanent debuff with no known cure, only some treatments that widely vary in their effectiveness. Despite this difficulty, it is worth it to try many cures to find what works, as depression does not end the game or remove the enjoyable side quests. It just ups the difficulty. Many players can lessen the debuff with therapy and antidepressants, while others have good luck with nature, exercise, dogs, or changing to a different quest on the same save file. To make money, go to your job and press A repeatedly. She's not interested in you, pal, just move on. Don't stick it in crazy / let crazy stick it in you. Life hack right here. We recommend starting location North America for new players, Asia for normal and Africa for survival experience. What's Europe? DLC content $29.99 to access. Warning. You have selected the default game mode, Hell on Earth. Life will be very difficult for you. In order to change your game mode, please go to the menu, enter the COMI code backwards and select a difficulty from the list. You cannot open the menu while in game.